Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my channel. Today, in this video, we are going to learn Class 10 English poem CLM, written by John Masefield. So let's read the poem and understand what is it. So let's get started. But before that, students, if you are viewing my video for the first time, do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get the notification of all the upcoming videos. To watch the video till end, and if you like it, hit the like button and share with your friends. And students, also visit the description box because the links have been provided of the important books of your syllabus, which will guide you and help you in preparation of your examinations. There are model question papers, solved papers of previous years. You have chapter wise, topic wise question papers, and many more important books of different subjects of math, science, social, English, Hindi. After all the subjects you will be getting there. So do visit the link, and also you have some accessories and stationaries and some general books which will be helpful for you all to gain more knowledge. So do visit the description box once and check the links. Okay, so now let's come back to the poem and let's get started. Let's see about the poet first. The poet is John Edward Masefield. From 1st June 1878 to 12th May 1967. He was an English poet and writer and poet laureate of the United Kingdom from 1930 until his death in 1967. He is remembered as the author of the classic children's novels, The Midnight Folk and The Box of Delights, and poems including The Everlasting Mercy and Sea Fever. Masefield was born in Lydburg in Herefordshire in Caroline. To Caroline and George Masefield, a solicitor. His mother died giving birth to his sister when Masefield was only six, and he went to live with his aunt. His father died soon after following a mental breakdown. Okay, so this is a history, a small information about the poet. He is remembered for his works and children novels, and he was born to Caroline and George Masefield, who was a solicitor, a lawyer, you can say. And here the poem is about his expression, his feelings towards his mother, the mother who died giving birth to his sister when he was only 6 years. So he went to live with his aunt, and after some days, his father too died because of a mental breakdown. So this is his history, and here in this poem we will get to see his emotion, his expression, his feelings towards his mother. So let's read the poem and understand. In the dark womb where I began, my mother's life made me a man. Through all the months of human birth, her beauty fed my common earth. I cannot see, nor breathe, nor stare, but through the death of some of her. So here the poet is saying, he is just recalling the days, and he is saying that in the dark womb where I began, how did his life begin in this world? Even when he was not born, he was in the womb of his mother, which was very dark. From there his life began, and my mother's life made me a man, and that is how he became a man, that the mother has given him a life, and that has made him a man today. Now, through all the months of human birth, how beauty fed my common earth. So all the months until which he was in the womb of the mother, the beauty of the mother had fed him and gave him all the strength to be a good person, or to be a good child, to be born in the common earth here. So it was just because of the mother, the beauty of the mother, the care the mother had taken all those 9 months in her womb to give him birth. He says, I cannot see, nor breathe, nor stir, but through the death of some of her. Now he says, I was not able to see in the womb. I was not able to breathe, nor I was able to move, nothing. But everything was just because of my mother. She used to take care. Because of her, I used to get everything, and that has caused her to death. And that is how, like, each time she gave birth to a child, it brought her more closer to the death. So it cost the life of the mother to give the birth to the child. So this expression, this emotion is being seen here in this first stanza. Okay, let's move on to the second one. Down in the darkness of the grave, she cannot see the lives she gave. For all her love, she cannot tell whether I use it ill or well. Nor knock at dusty doors to find her beauty dusty in the mind. Now he says, though because the mother is no more now, she was dead while giving birth to her sister, to his sister, while he was 6 years. So he felt that each time mother gave birth to a child, she was brought to more closer to the death. Now when she is no more, she is in the darkness of the grave, and she cannot see me from there. She cannot see her child from the grave. That the life which she has given to me, am I living it and using it properly, or am I not using it well? Because whatever love she has given it to me, whatever beauty, whatever care she has taken of me, and she has given me birth here, now she is no more present on the earth to see that whether I'm using that life properly in a good manner, or I'm just wasting it. Nor knock at dusty doors to find her beauty dusty in the mind. Nor we can see the her beauty, and nor we can find her now. Everything is in just in mind. All her beauty is now dusty. Okay, because after many years, as and when she used to give the birth, as and when she used to expect to give a birth to a child, she had to lose her beauty. Okay, so by losing her beauty, she has given birth to many children here. But now he is feeling so sad that mother is no more, and she is no more to see whether the child is doing well or ill. Okay, next. If the grave's gates could be undone, she could not know her little son. I'm so grown, if we should meet, she would pass by me in the street. Unless my soul's face let her see my sense of what she did for me. Now he says, even if the grave's gates could be undone, like even if the gates of the grave are open and she is brought again to birth, even if she is alive, even she is coming back, she would not recognize her little son now. The little son which she has left and gone long time ago, she will not be able to identify and recognize even if she is coming back now, because I am so much grown. And if even if we meet now, she would in the street, she will not be able to recognize me unless my soul's face let her see, unless my inner soul, unless my inner soul meets her and identifies her, my sense of what she did for me, whatever good things, whatever care she has taken for me. So unless and until my soul recognizes she recognizes my soul, we cannot meet and recognize each other, even though if she comes back here. So here the poet is missing the mother, and he is also saying the sacrifices she has done. Then, what have I done to keep in mind my debt to her and womankind? What woman's happier life repays her for those months of wretched days? For all my mouthless body leached, ever births realizing hell was reached. Now he says, what have I done to keep in mind my debt to her and womankind? He says, what have I done? Have I done anything to give back her all her sacrifices? It's debt on me. I have not cleared anything, nor I can clear it of any womankind. Like the process of giving birth to a child is upon all. You can never repay it back. So he's saying, what have I done to do that? And what woman's happier life repays her for those months of wretched days? Now, what are they getting instead of those wretched days, those months where they are bearing the pain and suffering and carrying the child in the wombs? We cannot repay that. Okay. Then, for all my mouthless body leached, air birds releasing, hell was reached. Now, all my mouthless means when he was in the womb, he was not able to use his mouth there. So even then he was getting all the nutritions and all the things he required. And that is how the mother was helping out, and she gave the birth, and she has reached to the death now. Next. What have I done or tried or said in thanks to that dear woman dead? Men triumph over women still. Men trample women's rights at will. And man's lust roves the world untamed. O grave, keep shut lest I be ashamed. Now, what have I done? He's asking the question again to himself. Have I done anything, or have I done anything to help the woman out or repay the sacrifice? Or in thanking to that dear woman dead, the woman who has dead, that is her mother. Have I thanked her or said her or tried to do something for her? Is asking to himself. And then he says, men triumph over women still. Men always try to suppress women. They try to take all their rights and will. Okay. And the man's lust just roam in the world here and there, and it's untamed. And so this all are such a bad thing. The woman who undergoes such a lot of pain and sacrifices her life to give a birth to a child, and you cannot repay it back. Instead, you are just curbing the rights. They're showing the success or victory over them. You are suppressing them. So he says, oh grave, keep shut lest I be shamed. So he wants the grave to be closed and the mother to be in, because he'll feel ashamed when she'll be out and she'll see this, that his son could not do anything for the sake of woman. He could not either say nor fight for it. So this is how the poet trying to show his emotion. He's feeling so sorry for the woman who have been undergoing such a lot of pain to give birth to a child, even at the cost of their own life. Okay, so here the sacrifice, the status of a woman has been shown in a very simple manner. The status of a mother cannot be replaced by anybody else. So this is a beautiful poem and emotional poem of the poet, which he has put over here. So I hope you all have understood the poem. I made it clear. If you like the video, do hit the like button and share with your friends. And do not forget to subscribe the channel, and also visit the description box to check the link. So we'll be back soon with more such videos. Till then, stay safe and take care. Thank you.